The boxing world celebrated Mexican Independence Day by renewing the Philippines versus Mexico ring rivalry. In Las Vegas, Juan Miguel Elorde, grandson of the legendary Flash Elorde, saw his world title hopes crushed by WBO junior featherweight champion Emmanuel Navarrete, who knocked him out in 4 rounds. However, in Carson, California, better results for a Filipino fighter. Ruthless Romero Duno and Ivan Striker Delgado went toe-to-toe for 7 rounds on Saturday night. Duno landed a series of power shots throughout the fight while also eating a few combinations from Delgado. But after too many overhand rights and inside combinations, Delgado looked gassed in the 7th round. He did not leave his corner for the 8th round, giving the 23-year-old from General Santos his 21st career win, 16th by knockout.
It was a good fight. I know that I was expecting that fight because I know that Ivan want to win this fight too.
In his post-fight interviews, Duno made sure to show the world who he wanted next, undefeated Ryan Garcia. The 24 hours leading up to the fight had taken a strange turn, when Garcia's original opponent, Avery Sparrow, was arrested for domestic violence charges. He was offered to fight Duno instead, but Golden Boy and Garcia's team could not come to terms, leading to a series of social media exchanges.
I know that he's not scared of me.
Yeah.
I know it, because I know that Ryan is a fighter too. That's why maybe he needs some time to think about it.
As Garcia sat out fight night entirely, he did chime in on Duno's performance. He took to Twitter to further clarify that his refusal to fight Duno on short notice was about standing up to the politics of boxing. And if that big time fight with Ryan Garcia does pan out for November, Duno will most likely stay stateside while continue training, ready for what may be the toughest test of his young career. Steve Angel, CBS-CBN News, Carson, California.